It's main event time on WCW Pro, and Dream on his way to the ring. Eddie Guerrero, he will face Juventud Guerrera. They may have to take the roof off of this building to keep these two in the ring.
Well, it's going to be a great matchup as we prepare for this big main event here on the Pro. Hours, minutes away. 60 men prepare for World War III only on pay-per-view. Pick up a telephone and call somebody. This is a must-buy pay-per-view because so much is at stake. Will the NWO completely destroy WCW tonight at this pay-per-view from Auburn Hills, or will WCW stand up? Will it be Luger? Will it be the Giant? Will it be somebody like Raven Steele Jr.? We don't know. Fit Finley, who knows? But bottom line, it's going to be something. There's a lot else going on, too, tonight on this pay-per-view.
Especially involving the man we just saw, Eddie Guerrero. He will defend the Cruiserweight title against the former champion, Rey Mysterio Jr. We talked earlier, that thing could get really out of control tonight on pay-per-view from the Palace of Auburn Hills. Guerrero defending against Rey Mysterio Jr. He's warming up with a tough contest against Juventud Guerrera today on the Pro.
I was always from that school that if I was going to go into a battle royal, something, I wanted to be hot. You know what I mean? Want to be warm.
Eddie Guerrero will be hot. We'll see this contest coming up next. Main event time on the Pro. Eddie Guerrero, the Cruiserweight champion, taking on Juventud Guerrera. And we're headed like a freight train to the Palace of Auburn Hills tonight for World War III. And Dream just announced for this big pay-per-view event, Ming and the Barbarian. We saw Ming and the Giant last night on Saturday night. Ming and the Barbarian with Jimmy Hart in their corner take on Glacier and Ernest Miller at the pay-per-view.
Well, I tell you what, Ming and Barbarian really on a roll right now. They want the World Tag Team title, and I look for that to be a great matchup.
Also, Rick and Scott Steiner, coming off that beating they took at the hands of the New World Order last Monday night, they will defend the World Tag Team Championship against the new team of Steve Regal and Dave Taylor.
Steiner's all the way. And just like in this situation right here, Juventud needs to get it done. We need to pack up all this stuff. Get a phone if you ain't got a ticket on the pay-per-view and get on to it because we are so close to this blockbuster pay-per-view must-buy situation. And Scott, as I said, Steiner's in there. I know one that's intriguing to you about the ring and all that stuff. And, you know, Goldberg and McMichaels. And so you've been asking me, who you going to pick in that?
I'm going to have to go with Bill Goldberg. The man is
you
just too tough.
You are crazy.
I think Steve McMichael can't keep his head together.
You act like a judge or something. Yeah. You know, I mean, what are we talking about?
Steve McMichael's lost it. McMichael's completely out of his mind.
You thought Goldberg a fellow Texican here, McMichael, and you know, well, let's go on with this thing here, dear. I'm going to give you another shot at it.
Okay.
Scotty Riggs and Raven. Now, who are you going to pick?
I got to go with Raven. He's got a screw loose. I think Raven can come in there and just take every punch. He can take everything Riggs has to offer and not feel a thing. And Scotty Riggs just can't do anything to Raven to hurt him, and Raven will just outlast him. And Riggs may lose his other eye, for Pete's sake.
Well, they are laying him in right here, and that's a good shot when you're talking about that. We already talked about Guerrero and Mysterio and Disco Inferno and Saturn. What a matchup that's going to be. But here's one for you. Then pick this one as we see Eddie Guerrero go to work. Ric Flair, Kurt Hennig.
Ric Flair.
Oh, boy, I'm going to tell you what. You judges that, I guarantee you, boy, that's easy. Is that easy?
You never pick against the Nature Boy, Dream. You know that. You never count out Ric Flair.
I picked against Ric Flair on three different occasions.
Yeah.
I became World Heavyweight Champion.
True.
I picked against Ric Flair. See, you'd have been broke by now if you'd have bet on him.
I'm broke now. But what about these words right here, Dream? No disqualification.
Well, let's go do something else.
He is the dirtiest player in the game. You know it. I know it. Everybody knows it. Kurt Hennig can't hang with Flair.
Well, we're going to find out. But you know what? When we ran that down, I don't want to be anywhere else. I know you don't either.
Uh-uh.
Anybody that loves our industry sees tonight an opportunity for WCW on pay-per-view to step up to the plate, you know what I mean, and hit a home run, right here at World War III.
We got one more, Dream. Ultimo Dragon and Yuji Nagata. This one intrigues me because if Ultimo Dragon wins it, he gets 5 minutes
with
Sonny Ono.
Yeah. Well, there you go. You told him all about it.
Well, Sonny Ono, he's not that bad, but he's a little guy. You can just break him in half, and Ultimo Dragon's one of the toughest around.
Well, you're speaking of guys that aren't that big that are tough, and a guy that can win a 60-man battle royal is one Eddie Guerrero. Make no mistake about it. As we look at this thing, what they've been laboring out here as we're making this run down, because it's getting late. It's getting time to pick up the phone. It's getting close to pay-per-view time, so you got to go ahead and get anxious about this thing. You know what I'm saying? You anxious, I'm anxious. Which man will step out? Which man will stand alone at the end tonight when it's all over? You ain't going to find out if you ain't bought it. And you got time to buy it right now.
And to call your cable company or satellite provider and
here
say,
you go.
I want World War III. Hoventude Prince hooks the leg and got the two count on the Cruiserweight champion. And Eddie almost lost the tune-up match for World War III.
Upset City was the going on right there. Getting ready to springboard right in the middle of the rope.
Hoventude twisting leg whip. Toy Boat hooks the leg, cover on Eddie, and he got the two count again.
Yeah, if I had tried that, I'd be a permanent part of that asphalt out there. I would never get sprung board in the right direction. I'd probably end up back the other way, you know what I mean?
Eddie,
I'm bottom heavy.
Eddie Guerrero is in trouble with Hoventude.
Here you go. Another high-risk maneuver.
Eddie's out. Hoventude going up top. Oh, wait a minute. Eddie, playing possum, Dream, just fooled it.
You think he was?
Eddie going up top, superplex coming up on Hoventude Guerrero. Oh boy, right into the center of the ring, and Eddie Guerrero taking over on Hoventude. He is ready.
Yeah, it might be Froggy Flash time. He might go ahead and get this thing wound up right here on the pro. What a pro show we've had.
Oh, and Eddie Guerrero with a frog splash. That's going to do it. He heads to World War III tonight against Ray Jr. He'll defend the Cruiserweight title. 60 men in three rings. The winner will get a shot at the World Heavyweight Championship next February at Super Brawl 8. Call your cable company right now or your satellite provider and order World War III. For the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, I'm Scott Hudson. See you tonight on Pay-Per-View.